Good morning, everybody. Myself, Raghuveer Jha. Today, I will read worksheet 7 and 8 of Unit 7. In previous class, we have read when a decimal number is divided by whole number, then decimal comes just above the dividend in quotient. Today, I will read that when a decimal number is divided by whole number and remainder does not come equal to 0, then we keep on adding 0 as long as the remainder does not become equal to 0. For example, when we divide a number 0.95 by 5, then its quotient is equal to 0.19. Here decimal point will come directly above the decimal point in the dividend, hence its quotient is equal to 0.19. When we divide 57.5 by 25, then quotient is 2.3 and remainder is 0. In next question, we divide 4.23 by 5. When we divide 4.23 by 5, then we observe that 5 8s are 40. So we place decimal before 8, and to understand decimal, we place 0. Here 0 is placed before decimal, indicate that whole number is 0. As 5 8s are 40, then remainder is 2 and 3, 23. 5 4s are 23. The remainder is now 3. It is not equal to 0, so we place 0. So we place 0 to make remainder 0. And hence 5 6 are 30. Then remainder comes 0. In this example, we understand that we keep on adding 0 and divide till no remainder is left. Here quotient is equal to 0.846 and remainder is equal to 0. Now we study some questions of worksheet 7. Divide the following. In question A, 0.5 divided by 2. When we divide 0.5 by 2, 2 to the 4, remainder is 1. We add a 0 on it to make the division continue. 2 5s are 10. Here remainder is 0. Thus, quotient is here equal to 0.25 and remainder is 0. In this type of division in which remainder does not become equal to 0, we keep on adding 0 as long as the remainder does not become equal to 0. When 11.7 divided by 6, 6 1s are 6. When we subtract 6 from 11, the remainder is 5. Now 6 9s are 54. Here remainder is 3, does not become equal to 0, so we add 0 on it to make division continue. 6 5s are 30. Thus now remainder become equal 0 and its quotient is 1.95 and remainder is 0. When 14.4 is divided by 12, 12 ones are 12. When we subtract 12 from 14, the remainder is 2. We place 4 on it, 24, 12 to the 24. Here remainder becomes equal 0, so there is no need of adding 0. The quotient is 1.2 and remainder is 0. Division of decimal numbers by 10, 100, 1000. To divide a decimal number by 10, 100, 1000, we just shift the decimal point in the quotient to the left by as many places as there are zeros in the divisor. Let us study these examples. 56.8 divided by 10 is equal to 5.68. Here decimal point is shifted one place to the left as there is 10. When we divide 438.5 by 100, decimal point is shifted 2 digits in the left side as there are 20. When we divide 105.2 by 1000, decimal point is shifted 3 digits in the left side as there are 3 0. So we observe from the above example that when we divide a decimal number by 10, 100, 1000, etc., then the decimal point is shifted in the left side as there are zeros on the one. Now we solve some questions of worksheet 8. Question number 1, find the quotient 44.81 divided by 1000 is equal to 0.04481. Since the number of zeros on 1 is 3, so decimal point is shifted 3 digits in the left side. As there is only 2 digits, so we put a 0 in the left side to make 3 digits. In B, when 1.3 is divided by 100, the quotient will be equal to 0.013. As there are 2 zeros on 1, so decimal is shifted 2 digits in the left side. When we divide 3.7 by any number, its quotient is equal to 0.37. That means we have to fill in the vacant place 10, because decimal is shifted 1 digit in the left side. In question B, 36 point divided by blank is equal to 0.362. Here we observe that decimal is shifted 2 digits in the left side, so we place 100 in the blank to make the statement complete. Now I give you some classwork to solve the problem. In question 1, divide the following: A, 12.06 divided by 12, B, 3.75 divided by 6, in C, 3.4 divided by 4, in D, 9.2 divided by 16, in E, 1.3 divided by 100, in F, 2.56 divided by 1000, and in G, 148.5 divided by 10. Question number 2, fill in the boxes. In A, 3.7 divided by box is equal to 0.37. In B, 77.1 divided by box is equal to 0.771. In C, 710.3 divided by box is equal to 7.103. And in D, 819.4 divided by box is equal to 0.8194. And in E, 36.2 divided by box is equal to 0.362. In HW, do worksheet 7 and 8 of unit 7. Thank you and have a nice day, all of you.